Hello, dear students. In the earlier episode of this chapter, we have looked into the meaning, definition, and advent of biotechnology. We have also discussed genetic engineering, which includes creation of recombinant DNA, use of gene cloning and gene transfer, and maintenance of sterile ambience as the two core techniques of biotechnology. We also inferred to the basic steps of genetically modifying an organism. In the present episode of this chapter, we will discuss the various tools of recombinant DNA technology. Dear students, as we have discussed that genetic engineering or recombinant DNA technology can be accomplished only if we have the key tools, which are restriction enzymes, polymerase enzymes, ligases, vectors, and the host organism. Let us try to understand them. The first tool is restriction enzymes. In the year 1963, the two enzymes responsible for restricting the growth of bacteriophage in Escherichia coli were isolated. One of these added methyl group to DNA and is known as restriction endonucleases, HIND2, while the other cut DNA and is known as restriction endonuclease. The restriction endonuclease HIND2's functioning depended on a specific DNA nucleotide sequence, which was isolated and characterized 5 years later. It was found that HIND2 always cut DNA molecules at a particular point by recognizing a specific sequence of 6 base pairs. This specific base sequence is known as the recognition sequence for HIND2. Besides HIND2, today we know more than 900 restriction enzymes that have been isolated from over 230 strains of bacteria, each of which recognize different recognition sequences. The convention for naming these enzymes is that the first letter of the name comes from the genus and the second two letters come from the species of the prokaryotic cell from which they were isolated. For example, in ECO-R1, ECO comes from Escherichia coli RY13. The letter R is derived from the name of the strain. Roman numbers following the names, which is 1 in this case, indicate the order in which the enzymes were isolated from the strain of bacteria. Restriction enzymes belong to a large class of enzymes called nucleases. These are of two kinds. The first is exonucleases and the second one is endonucleases. Exonucleases remove nucleotides from the end of the DNA, whereas endonucleases make cuts at specific positions within the DNA. Each restriction endonuclease functions by inspecting the length of a DNA sequence. Once it finds its specific recognition sequence, it will bind to the DNA and cut each of the two strands of the double helix at specific points in their sugar phosphate backbones. Here in this diagram, we can observe that the formation of recombination DNA by action of restriction endonuclease enzyme ECO-R1 is happening. The restriction enzyme cuts both strands to the vector DNA at the same time, whereas ECO-R1 cuts the DNA between bases guanine and adenine only when the sequence GAATTC is present in the DNA. Due to this, sticky ends are formed, where the DNA fragments of the vector DNA and the foreign DNA join to form a recombinant DNA. Each restriction endonuclease recognizes a specific palindromic nucleotide sequence in the DNA. Palindromes are groups of letters that form the same words when read both forward and backward. For example, Malayalam. The palindrome in DNA is a sequence of base pairs that reads same on the two strands when orientation of reading is kept the same. For example, the following sequences reads the same on the two strands in 5 prime to 3 prime direction. This is also true if read in 3 prime to 5 prime direction. The entire process of recombinant DNA technology can be seen through this diagram. Here, the restriction enzymes cut the strand of DNA a little away from the center of the palindrome sites, but between the same two bases on the opposite strands. This leaves single-stranded portions at the ends. We can see that there are overhanging stretches called sticky ends on each strand. These are named so because they form hydrogen bonds with their complementary cut counterparts. This stickiness of the ends facilitate the action of the enzyme DNA ligase. Restriction endonucleases are used in genetic engineering to form recombinant molecules of DNA, which are composed of DNA from different sources or genomes. When cut by the same restriction enzyme, the resultant DNA fragments have the same kind of sticky ends, and these can be joined together end to end using the enzyme DNA ligases. Here, it is to be noticed that normally, unless we cut the vector and the source DNA with the same restriction enzyme, the recombinant vector molecule cannot be created. The next tool of recombinant DNA technology is the cloning vectors. A cloning vector is a small piece of DNA taken from a virus, a plasmid, or the cell of a higher organism that can be stably maintained in an organism and into which a foreign DNA fragment can be inserted for cloning purposes. The vector, therefore, contains features that allow for the convenient insertion or removal of DNA fragment in or out of the vector. Here, in this diagram, we can observe the E. coli cloning vector PBR322. Dear students, now we should see the next required tool of recombinant DNA technology. It is the competent host, which is required for transformation with recombinant DNA. As we know that DNA is a hydrophilic molecule, it cannot pass through cell membranes. In order to force bacteria to take up the plasmid, the bacterial cells must first be made competent to take up DNA. This is done by treating them with a specific concentration of a divalent cation, such as calcium, which increases the efficiency with which DNA enters the bacterium through pores in its cell wall. Recombinant DNA can then be forced into such cells by incubating the cell with recombinant DNA on ice, followed by placing them briefly at 42 degrees centigrade in order to give a heat shock, and then putting them back on ice. This enables the bacteria to take up the recombinant DNA. Students, here you should know that this is not the only way to introduce alien DNA into host cells. Microinjection is a method in which recombinant DNA is directly injected into the nucleus of an animal cell. Whereas, in other methods, which is known as biolistics or gene gun and is suitable for plants, cells are bombarded with high velocity microparticles of gold or tungsten coated with DNA. With this, the episode on tools for constructing recombinant DNA comes to its end. In the next episode, we will discuss the processes facilitating recombinant DNA technology. Thank you.